Call of Duty, one of the most popular video game franchises in history, one of the most criticized video game franchises in history, and one of my favorite video game franchises in history.
Hey y'all, how you doing? What is this dream you're pursuing? What are these feelings you mention? Are you from a different dimension? Are you my nigga? Do you have dementia?
Yo, what is going on, everyone? It's Pandora back again with another video. And in this one, I'm going to be giving my opinion on the Black Ops 4 multiplayer beta, how I think the full game is going to be at launch, blackout, zombies, multiplayer, etc. We're going to be talking about it here today, so let's get right into it. Alright, in this first match, we got Heist on the newest map added to the game just yesterday, Hacienda. Honestly, this map, it's not the best, but it's not bad. It could be better, but it's not bad. That's all I'm going to say about it. There's some nice close quarter combat areas. There's nice long range areas. It's just 50-50 for me. It's nice for SMGs, nice for ARs. Not that good for sniping in my opinion, but for the most part it's a good map. Now this heist mode, on the other hand, this mode is by far one of the best modes to be added to Call of Duty in a long time, in my opinion. It's basically CSGO in Call of Duty. You start off with a pistol, the Strife pistol. Everybody gets it off the bat. And you earn cash as the game progresses. You start off with 500 off the bat. And with this cash, you're able to buy upgrades for the pistol. You're able to buy ammo for the pistol. You're able to buy different primaries, so ARs, snipers, SMGs, anything really. You can buy attachments for those guns. You can buy frags. You can buy different equipment, perks, you name it. You can buy it. The more you win, the more cash you get. And it's basically just it's a really fun mode. It's just a really fun mode. The maps go well with it. And it's like search and destroy. There's 5v5, and except you don't die instantly. You get knocked, basically. So it's like a BR. You get knocked, you can get revived, and you can't buy med kits or anything like that. You find them scattered across the map. You can carry a max of 2 meds, and you can carry you can just carry a shit ton of ammo, basically. But they're scattered across the map. You can pick them up whenever you need them. And it's just a really fun mode. That's all I really got to say about it. Now, the play of the game stuff, I really, really don't like that much. Yeah, it's a cool concept from Overwatch and all that, but that should just stay in Overwatch. It shouldn't come to Call of Duty. And it's like Final Kill Cam was just, it was just so much better. But the reason I say that right now is because the play of the game in Black Ops 4 is kind of shit. Like, you can literally just get a split triple and it's the play of the game. It's ridiculous. You don't have to do anything to get the play of the game. And yeah, this is what I mean right there, where you just saw you could buy different attachments for the pistols, you can buy different attachments for the SMG at different costs. The higher the cost, the better the attachments are, obviously. But this SMG right here, I don't even know what to say. This was my go-to for the entire beta after I unlocked this SMG. The SOG 9mm. This thing is straight up diesel. It will melt from close to medium. Long range doesn't have much effectiveness, but this thing is a beast. 36 rounds in a single mag. Fire rate is fucking insane. Reload speed's nice. Barely any recoil. If you pop a grip, really, that's the only attachment you need on it is just a grip, and you will be absolutely unstoppable. You can move so fast with this thing. You can just play. It's just overall just a gun to use if you want to have fast gameplay. Just go to the close quarter areas of the map. You can absolutely destroy with it. And it is just, like I said, one of my go-tos right next to the SCAR in this game. It is just absolutely crazy. I wouldn't be surprised if this would get nerfed in the full game, but it's pretty great. Pretty great gun, and right there you just saw me, I extracted the cash. This mode isn't just about killing the whole enemy team, it has an objective behind it. There's a random bag of cash that spawns at, I think, 3 different locations on every map, around the middle, left, and right lanes of the map. You have to grab that, and then after you grab it, it will spawn an extraction site that you have to take the cash to and extract it in this little zone. It's almost like a capture the flag type of thing. But yeah, right here, you see you can also buy armor ranging from light to heavy armor. Light being the least expensive at 500, and then it goes on to medium armor. That's 1500, and then to the most overpowered armor, heavy, at 2k. You were just a fucking bullet sponge when you have heavy armor on in this mode. I shit you not. You can just eat so many shots from no matter what gun it is, you eat. So yeah, guys, there's not much left to commentate right here for now, so I'm just going to have some music playing in the background while the gameplay plays out, and I'll see you guys in a few minutes.
Yeah. If I could go back to that day we met, I probably would just stay in bed. You run your mouth all over town, and this one goes out to the sound of breaking glass on my Range Rover. Pay me back, good Richard Chover. All the presents I would send, fuck my friends behind my shoulder. Next time I'ma stay asleep, I pray the Lord my soul to keep. And you've been drinking lately, bitch, you crazy. And I'm such a good in love, I wrote a little song for ya. It go like, so fucking done with all the games you play. I ain't gonna keep it. Since the X and O's, I'm enough to know I'm done. On another note, I'm ghost. If I could go back to that day we met, I probably would've stayed in bed. You wake up every day and make me feel like I'm incompetent. Designer shoes is NX tabs, compliments your makeup bag. You never had to buy yourself a drink, cause everybody wants to tap that ass. You got me thinking lately, bitch, you crazy. And nothing's ever good enough, I wrote a little song for ya. It go like, oh, Ray, me, fa, so fucking done with you, girl. So fucking done with all the games you play. I ain't no dictator. Save the X and O's on another note, I'm done.
And now we move on to the mode Control on the map Seaside. Control is basically hardpoint with a limited amount of lives and only 2 hardpoint zones. On this one, there's 2 hardpoint zones labeled A and B. And if you're defending it, each team has a total number of 30 lives they can use. After that, when there's only 5 people left, once you die, you're out. It turns into heist, or it turns into search and destroy almost for whatever team only has 5 lives left. After that, round ends, you win. If the enemy team captures both points, they win the round, you lose. Doesn't matter if you have all your lives or not still. Pretty fun mode overall. Very fast paced. Can become pretty intense at most times. I've only played it on this map. This is my first game of it. But it was a pretty good first impression. I am looking forward to playing this on all the other maps they add in the game. Really good addition. Almost as good as Heist, but I don't think anything's going to beat Heist in a long time. And right here you see I earned my gunship and strafing run. This is my first time getting those high streaks in this game. The strafing run is basically just the Warthog from BO2. The gunship is just an AC-130. You'll be seeing gameplay of both here soon in this same match. But in my opinion, the gunship can be better. Something about it just feels weird to control. I don't know. It's just weird. You'll see it here right about now. I'm pulling out the gunship. It's basically just like the AC-130 from MW2 and 3 almost. But it is not a very good streak to use on this map, at least. I don't know what the objective spots are located on the other maps for this mode. But these two are both inside, so it was pretty hard to get kills with this thing unless they just spawned right in front of my crosshairs. But the thing about this, it was kind of hard to locate the enemies on this map because it was in thermal and the squares were bright red, so I could barely even see them most of the time. I don't know if there's a way to change it to like normal color. I don't know if you can change it to not be thermal, but if they can change that, if they can make it so it's easier to see, then it would be a much better score streak. I only got I got under 10 kills with this thing. So it could be better. It's not bad, but it could be better. Not good on a map and mode combination like this, but I took it. I liked it. So, and then here you'll be seeing the strafing run come in soon. Like I said, it's basically the Warthog from BO2, but I feel like the BO2 version was a lot better than this one. Yeah, right about here, I called in the Warthog, and it was a really good streak. It killed a few people. Obviously, like I said before, the streaks in this game were not that good, or the streaks I had at the time were not that good for this map and mode combo because of how the objectives were inside. But it got me a few kills. Still as good as it was in BO2. Maybe a little bit better, but the streaks in this game overall were pretty good. RCXD is fun to use. I'm glad it's back. Hellstorm, Mistle, and Lightning Strike are just as good as they were in BO2 and 3. There's the Strike Team, which spawns two armored like AI that just clap everything they see. There's a Mantis, which is basically the AGR or the Cerberus of this game. It walks around on four legs and just has a turret and shoots shit. And there's the Attack Choppers, it's the Cobra, whatever you want to call it. This thing destroys everything it sees. It's a beast, obviously. And that's really all I can really think of the streaks off the top of my head. But overall, the streaks in this game are really fun. Really fun to use, really good. Haven't seen a VSAT, though. I don't know if the Hater was in the BO3 beta, but I hope they bring that back, too. Now, this game, to me, it feels really fresh. It feels new. Like, people say Call of Duty is the same shit, different year. But this Call of Duty is different. This Call of Duty feels fresh. It feels new. It feels unique. I'm not just saying that because it's boots on the ground. I generally think this COD has a chance to be one of the best CODs of all time. That might be a stretch. That might be a shot in the dark. That might be me reaching. But I stick to it. I'm going to stick by it for as long as I can. Blackout seems somewhat promising. The zombies is going to be out of the fucking world. And multiplayer, it's grown to me already. I love the multiplayer. It's just so much fun. Like, this Call of Duty brought me back to, like, BO2 days. It just makes me feel, like, obviously, it makes me feel like a beast again on Call of Duty. But it's just overall fun to play. Going to be one of my favorite CODs of all time. It's going to be up there. But I can't wait for this to launch in October. Can't wait to play the Blackout beta in September. It's going to be fun to play. I'm going to make sure to have videos on that. That's all I have for this one. Hope you all enjoyed it, and I'll see you on the next one. I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I